أستثبت بالذي هو خير وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. Today, in this day of Eid, we remember the Hajjis, the pilgrims, who are finishing their Hajj and soon coming back to their countries. But when we remember them and when we celebrate Eid, we remember also Ibrahim alayhi salam and his family. This family that went with the battalion through many trials, through many tests from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's remember on this day of Eid that Mecca al-Mukarramah was established by a lone mother and her infant child when Ibrahim alayhi salam left her in a desert, in a place that has nothing to live. But because it was the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the young mother asked Ibrahim, the prophet of Allah, is this what Allah asked you to do? And when he said yes, she showed a level of faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beyond imagination. She said to him, go, we will not be left alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us. And soon, the Mecca, the town of Mecca, as we know it, was established. And when we remember Hajj and look at the rituals of Hajj, we remember that this young mother was going between Safa and Marwa 7 times looking for water for her young infant. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought it to her. This is a great thing to remember in these days. And then we remember that Ibrahim alayhi salam came to visit his young son and went through another test when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Ibrahim to sacrifice his son. A great test for the father and for the son, and both of them passed the test and submitted to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah gave Ismail alayhi salam a substitute, a great substitute. وَفَدَيْنَاهُ بِذِبْحٍ عَظِيمٍ. This is a great achievement in the history of the family of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Then another achievement, another eternal achievement, that they built the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذْ يَرْحَمُ إِبْرَاهِيمُ الْقَوَاعِدَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَاعِيلَ. They laid the foundation of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what did they say? رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. Oh Allah, accept our deeds. They did not pray. They did not say, this is a great honor. All they said, تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. Accept, oh Allah, these deeds that we have done for you, accept it from us. And today, we do the same prayers. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept whatever good deeds we have done. And when we look at these events that materialize in Hajj, we remember the achievement of a family consisting at one time of a father who lived away from his son and from his wife, consisting sometimes from a lone mother with her son living away from their father. And at some time, a young son with his father building the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a lesson for every one of us, that you have a role to play. Whether you are a young man like Ismail alayhi salam, whether you are a father like Ibrahim, whether you are a lone mother like Hajar, you can do lots of good things. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring His blessings to whatever you do. Whatever you do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will accept it as long as you do it for His sake. And as long as you follow what Ibrahim and his son said, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا. Oh Allah, accept what we do for your sake. In these days, we remember the needy and the poor for with our qurbani, with our udhiya. For this is something to show them that even on the day of happiness, even when we have joy, even when we have nice meals at our homes, we remember them. And we want them to share some of the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with us. This is the spirit of the Eid al Adha. This is the spirit of remembering Ibrahim alayhi salam. This is the spirit of remembering Hajar. This is the spirit of remembering Ismail alayhi salam. And this is the spirit of saying, لبيك اللهم لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر ولله الحمد. And when we remember the sacrifice of Ibrahim alayhi salam, that he was ready to sacrifice his son. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, Iran, to tell him and to tell humanity that you will not be come near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by shedding the blood of your brother in humanity. You become near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by making a sacrifice that will feed your brother in humanity, that will help your brother in humanity. This is a tradition, sacrificing human sacrifices, a tradition that started when humanity veered from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They thought that by killing a human being, you could be near to Allah. And in this gesture, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the humanity, no more shedding human blood. If Ismail alayhi salam was given a substitute, then you can be near to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by following the example of Ibrahim and following the example of Ismail. And when we remember this, we remember that in the lands where Ibrahim was born, in the lands where Ibrahim walked through, there is bloodshed today. Very painful bloodshed. Some of it is being shed by the name of Islam, wrong, and crimes are committed by the name of Islam that wouldn't be further away from Islam. And some of it is shed by Western governments who are doing the same wrong things by bombing our people. Someone told us that we have been bombed 3 times. One time by the regime, by the tyrant government. Another time by those heretics. And the third time by the Western government. This is the wrong approach. No one is talking about the root causes of these problems. What are the root causes of these problems? It is the absence of freedom, the absence of transparency, the absence of the free will and respect for the people, and the presence of sectarianism, the presence of corruption, the presence of tyranny, and they are being supported again and again. The mistakes are being repeated again and again, and Muslim blood is being shed again and again, unfortunately. And we should always voice our opposition to this kind of act that has no planning, that we were not consulted as Muslims. We were not asked about our opinion, about the solution. All it takes is just to send some bombs and the problem will be solved, we are told. But we know this is not true. We know that this is compounding the problem instead of solving. And we should voice our opposition to this today, tomorrow, and every time injustice is committed. We should point out the root causes of these problems. And we should ask always that Muslims should be treated like others, with dignity, and their freedom is being respected. Their transparency, their quest for transparency and democracy in their countries should be respected and assisted. We should not assist tyrants. We should not assist people who have blood on their hands. Having said all of this, we have among us a very compassionate politician who will address you, and she will be talking to you very soon. We have seen her, and she has addressed many of our concerns as Muslims, and she has taken great steps in the politics of Ontario to include Muslims in the government and in the system, and we appreciate her presence and participation. Let's all pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring His blessings to all of us on this day, and to help the Muslim woman to overcome the troubles that it is meeting time after time, in place after place. Allahumma ajma'na ala ma yurdi, wa hul baynana wa bayna ma'asi, wa ja'alna min al-mutahabbin fi. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Allahumma ansur al-islam wal muslimin. Allahumma man arada al-islam wal muslimin khayran fawaffiqhu li kulli khayr. ومن أراد بالإسلام والمسلمين شرا فخذه أخذ عزيز المهتدى. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا إلا غفرته، ولا هما إلا فرجته، ولا عيبا إلا سترته، ولا مريضا إلا شفيته، ولا غائبا إلا إلى أهله رددته. اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم ارحم موتانا، اللهم اجعل الجنة مثواه. اللهم أغننا بحلالك عن حرامك، وبطاعتك عن معصيتك، وبك عن سواك. الله أكبر.